Hi everybody, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now, I get a lot of questions about protein powders, and rightly so. There's so much confusion about it. Lots of misinformation. And of course, this is because there's so many different protein powders and different types, which only adds to the confusion. So today, I'm going to reveal everything you want and need to know about protein powders. For example, how much total protein you need during the day, as well as with each meal. What's the best and worst proteins for building muscle and losing fat? What's the best protein for just health and longevity? I also discuss vegetarian, vegan protein sources, which are the best. And I'll tell you what I use personally. And best of all, how you can make your own customized protein powder with any kind of protein you want, different flavors, different tastes, and various ingredients that you can add to it. And the coolest part about it, it will cost you less money than buying from any other protein powders that you see online or in the stores. In fact, this is how I have been getting my own protein powders for over a decade now. And you'll get my contacts, the website, the discounts, and the custom formula. And this is the first time I'm making this information public, so please pay attention. This is because it's such an important topic, right? I've decided to turn this into a two-part series, and most likely I'll make an additional third part with frequently asked questions. Now, I'm putting all this time and effort in this for you because I'm just like you, all right? I used to be totally confused about protein. In fact, in the old days, I used to buy some crash weight gain powder by Joe Weider, and it was Arnold Schwarzenegger on the product, right? And I'll be honest with you, it was junk, but that's all we had back then. Later, I would buy these big tubs of protein. It was called something like Mega Weight Gainer or Mega Mass or something like that. Again, it was by Weider. Anyway, it tasted good, right? It had lots of calories, which I needed because I was just so really skinny at the time. But it was cheap protein. It was just mainly milk and sugar. Sadly, I was just gassy and bloaty all the time because, again, it was made out of junky protein and junky ingredients. Then everything changed when I met Jeff Everson and Dr. Scott Connolly, who helped create Metrics. Now, it originally came in two bottles, a base and a plus, and later it came in a single convenient packets, all right? Now, Metrics changed everything. It contained much better protein, lower carbs, and lower calories. Had very little gas or bloat. It was good. Later, similar meal replacement powders or ready-to-drink RTD solutions came along, such as EAS's Myoplex. However, the next big change came when pure whey protein was released, and one of the most popular was promoted by one of my mentors, Dan Duchesne, called Designer Whey. Now, when pure whey protein was released, it was one of the best proteins you could buy, and at that time, it really was. And it's still one of the most popular proteins these days. Now these days, you know, there's a lot more advances and better proteins. And one of the biggest changes is also vegan, non-dairy proteins, which are almost as good and as digestible as whey protein, which is great because you no longer have to worry about losing muscle if you don't want to have animal protein. Plus, in all honesty, having more vegan veggie protein is actually better for your health and longevity. Now, I'm sharing all this history with you to let you know that I've been doing this for a long time, all right? So I've been there, done that, and I want you to learn from my mistakes. So with that said, let's start with the top questions and answers. So the first question is, how much protein do you really need? Now, people selling the protein powders are always pushing you to eat more protein, but you don't need to. Listen, I've tried as little as 0.5 grams per pound of body weight, which was 100 grams or 400 calories, to as high as 3 grams per pound of body weight, which is 600 grams daily. That's 2,400 calories. More will not build any extra muscle, especially in the long run. And if anything, it'll increase muscle breakdown, which I've also done a video about this as well. Plus, it's just very unhealthy to have so much protein. What I found is the most amount of protein you really need is about 1 gram per pound of body weight. Now, I weigh about 200 pounds, and I eat about 200 grams. That's 800 calories. Even if you're taking steroids and working out really hard, you really don't need any more protein. In fact, I'd rather you ate more fat and carbohydrates. Now, the next question is, how much protein per meal? Listen, I've read all the studies and listened to all the experts about this. There are studies showing that your body can only absorb about 10 grams per hour, depending on the type of protein, whey being one of the best. Another source shows that only 20 grams per meal, that's roughly about every 2 or 3 hours, is required for maximum protein synthesis. Eating more didn't increase protein synthesis. And another study, it showed eating all the protein in one meal instead of four made no difference. Granted, the study was with women who only ate 50 grams of protein daily. And in an intermittent fasting study, eating all the protein during 4 hour time window and then fasting for 20 hours didn't cause muscle loss. However, it also didn't cause muscle gains, any extra protein synthesis either. Now, there are lots of factors here. Age, the type of proteins you eat, your hormonal profile being the most important, and what you're eating with the protein, such as fats and carbs and fiber and so forth, all make a difference. However, let me keep it simple for you. Try to eat between 25 to 40 grams of protein per meal, spreading out evenly throughout the day. Now, this is important because protein is the only macronutrient that can't really be stored. Carbs get stored in the muscle and liver. Fat gets stored in the fat cells, but protein needs to be replenished throughout the day. So for me, eating 200 grams, I'll spread it over 5 to 7 meals, which comes out to about 25 to 40 grams per meal. And I do this because I just feel better, right? I don't get bloated eating a massive meal of protein. It also keeps my stomach flatter than having all that food, right, in 2 or 3 big meals. Now, the next question is, what's the worst protein for building muscle and losing fat? Now, if I had to pick one protein source you should avoid, it's soy. Unfortunately, it's in everything because it's cheap and it's been genetically modified. However, the reason I don't like it is because it increases estrogen level, which then causes a decrease in testosterone. Plus, estrogen is a primary causing factor for both breast and prostate cancer. So there's your muscle loss. Additionally, soy decreases thyroid production, especially, and you know, this is the primary hormone being the T3 thyroid, which controls your metabolism. And there's your cause for fat gain with soy. So stay away from it. The next question is, what are the best proteins for gaining muscle and losing fat? This is a question everyone wants to know. If I have to pick one, it comes down to whey protein. However, not any kind of whey, because I believe most of them just aren't good. I think the best is whey isolate, and more specifically, cold filtration, grass-fed whey isolate. And I'll tell you where you get the special blend in part 2 of this video series. Now, the benefits of whey isolate is that it has the highest branched-chain amino acids. These are the 3 most abundant aminos in the muscle. It helps boost your immune system. There's also no lactose or sugar, so it causes very little stomach discomfort. It's also easy to digest, and it's fast absorbable. And it has the highest biological value, absorbable protein at 104, whole eggs being the next highest at a perfect 100. Now, there's also whey protein concentrate. This is like a cheaper form and also has lactose and causes stomach problems. Unfortunately, this is typically added into the protein powders and protein bars because it's, again, cheap and it gives the illusion that you're getting a lot more whey. But it's the wrong type of whey, all right? Don't buy it and stay from it. Stay away from it, all right? Now, other sources of milk protein, one of them being micellar casein, all right? This is a slower digesting protein. It's something you use before going to bed, so it slowly releases while you're sleeping, but not before or after a workout. Now, it doesn't have the same immune-boosting benefits nor as high a concentration of branched-chain aminos as whey isolate. Lastly, there's hydrolyzed caseinate, which is also milk. It's faster and easier to digest than micellar casein, but it also costs over 3 times the price of it, as well as the whey isolate. It's not worth the extra cost. It also doesn't have all the same benefits of the whey isolate, again, with the branched chain and immune function and so forth. It's just too expensive to manufacture and not really worth the extra benefits, in my opinion. And like I said, in video 2, I'll show you exactly where and how you get the best whey isolate. And if you want, you can actually blend in other proteins in it as well, so you get your own customized formula. Now, the next question is, what about vegetarian vegan proteins? All right. As you may know from watching my previous videos, I'm not a fan of dairy, certainly not milk. I think that milk is for babies and cow milk is for baby cows. So the most I'd suggest is 25 grams of whey isolate once daily, preferably just during or after your workout. However, the good news is that there's lots of great vegetable protein powders that have almost the same benefits, digestibility, and absorbability of whey isolate, but without having to eat dairy. Now, the first one is there's pea protein, all right, which is in a lot of vegetarian protein powders and bars. Now, I'm not a fan of it because it causes inflammation and it's hard to mix. Now, it might be good for a bar because it makes a nice, solid, chewable bar, but not for a drink. Then there's hemp protein, which is great, but it's hard to have it as a primary source. It's just hard to mix, and it does kind of taste like grass and dirt. Then we have alfalfa protein. Again, similar to hemp, it's a green protein, which is good for alkalizing your body, which I believe is important. However, just like hemp, it's not good by itself, all right? It's better to mix it with other protein types. And finally, we have my favorite, rice protein, non-GMO. Now, there's no sugar, it's easy to digest, and here's the best part. In a 2013 nutritional journal study showed that rice protein is just as effective as whey protein in gaining muscle, losing fat, and improving exercise performance. Now, again, in video number 2, I'll show you ways that you can blend these vegetable proteins for all the benefits, but still have it taste good. But, you know, if you had to pick one veggie protein source, again, I'd go with the non-GMO rice protein. And the final and last question is, what about other types of proteins, right? Now, there's other types of proteins other than dairy or vegetable protein, right? There is egg protein powder, which is only egg white or whole eggs. I don't like only egg white because you're missing half the amino acids that are found in the yolk. And I'd much rather you just ate whole, fresh, pasture-raised eggs. They have a lot more health benefits than the powder, all right? Then there's collagen protein, which has become popular over the past 5 or 10 years. I think there are lots of, you know, it's beneficial for skin, hair, and joints, which is always nice, but nothing extra for building muscle and losing fat if that's your primary goal. Finally, there's bone broth protein, again, which has recently become very popular. Similar to collagen protein, has many benefits for skin, hair, especially joints, and also your gut. All very important, but again, nothing extra for gaining muscle and fat loss. So go ahead and use collagen and bone broth protein to increase your total protein calories during the day if you'd like, for the added health benefits of your skin, your hair, your joints, and your gut. So in summary, there you have it. I think I've covered all the main proteins. I know there's others such as insect protein powders and so forth. I'll save those rare ones for another video. As a quick summary, I think the best protein is grass-fed cold filtration whey isolate. The best veggie protein being non-GMO rice protein. Feel free to add in some collagen and or bone broth protein for skin, hair, joint, and gut. And also in my next video, I'll show you how you can make your own protein powder, customize it with any percentage ratio of protein you want, different flavors, other additives such as branched chain aminos or creatine, glutamine, and so forth. And the best part is you'll actually save money because you'll be getting it direct from the manufacturer, and there are no minimums either. So you can order just 1 pound or 100 pounds and still get that bulk wholesale discount. Plus, I've spoken with the owners and I'll be giving you a special coupon for an added bonus discount. This is how I make my own protein and have been doing so for over a decade. And again, I'm not here to sell you anything, just to show you the solution that I personally use for, again, over a decade. This way you can get the best protein and save money at the same time. So there you have it for part one. If you found this video helpful, please do me a favor and subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and share it with other people who may benefit as well. And finally, watch part two of this video by clicking the link in the description area, and I'll show you how you can formulate your own customized protein and save money and save time as well. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.